all hail rock and roll of a Monday night. This is Jason. Actually, coming out, an amazing version by Shaken Stevens, Sea of Love. The new album by Shaken Stevens is out this month, and it's called Now Listen. And I've been listening to it, and listening online a little bit as well, to some of the little snippets you can get on Shaken Stevens' website. It's a great album for Christmas, particularly the one that he's got on the new album, which is a cover of a Beatles number. It is so cleverly done. I'm not even going to tell you which one it is. You have to go out and buy it or look it up yourself. Now then, if I had a TARDIS, I would probably take you back in time by about 2 or 3 months to the Uckfield Carnival, and on the last particular night, this particular show went out live at the Uckfield Civic Centre, as I was up live on stage with the Jive Aces, who are an amazing local act, and we're always pleased to play their music on this show. And if you didn't actually make it down to see the Jive Aces at the Civic Centre here in Uckfield, I'm going to transport you back in time to hear how good they sounded with their song Bona Sera, where they actually pulled a lady out of the audience and danced to her, and it's such a clever song. The next voice you hear will be me introducing the band, and then you get to hear that most magnificent song live. It's Sunday, it's 7:30, and we are live from the Civic Centre. Welcome to Hail, Hail Rock and Roll on Uckfield FM, at the heart of your community, celebrating the last day of the Uckfield Festival. We're live on FM 105, and if you happen to be in your cars right now, picking us up, lock that on as one of your presets in your car radios, and you'll only be a button away from being at the heart of your community. Now, it's a triple cast today, so those who are listening on the line, the World Wide Web, on uckfieldfm.co.uk, and you've never heard of Uckfield before, may I introduce Uckfield to you. It is a town on the Weald district of East Sussex in southern England. It's located on the southern edge of the Weald and on the River Uck, and is one of the tributaries to the Ouse, the mighty Ouse. If you're ever going to call a river anything, I'd probably call it the Ouse as well. Uckfield, the name actually, is an ancient Celtic British word meaning high place, and the first mention of the historical documents goes back as far as the 13th century, although the local architect here in the town tells us that 9000 BC there was some Stone Age finds here, so it goes back even further. Uckfield developed as a stopping off point for the pilgrims on the route between Canterbury and also Chichester and Lewes, but today we're here to celebrate a history of a very different kind, because this is rock and roll.
Jason Rushworth.
And roll here of a Monday night. Thanks for coming, by the way. 20 past the hour of 7. I just heard I Need a Man by Barbara Pittman. She was one of the few female singers to record at Sun Studios. A young teenager she was, and recorded demos with others, but she was around the studio for a lot of her time and just befriended most of the artists. And let me tell you, that is how to get into music. You just hang around studios long enough and eventually someone will let you behind a microphone. Well, that's what happened to me anyway. She did her own record tour, and Barbara performed many tours over her short career, and a most popular song, she just heard it, I Need a Man. It's on the Sun label, and Two Young Fools in Love was the other one, released on the Sam Phillips International label. And it's thought that she could have had much more success, except that she didn't receive much promotion. And as we all know from things like The X Factor, you need promotion. Now, if she was on The X Factor today, she'd clean up. These guys next, if they're on The X Factor, they'd have cleaned up 2 weeks ago during the Halloween performance, because Little Red Riding Hood is up next by the Meteors. Now, if you don't actually know these, you probably will when you hear them anyway. The Meteors are a British psychobilly band formed in 1980. Originally from the United Kingdom. They often credited as giving psychobilly the subgenre of that to which we play its first birth. It kind of fused rockabilly and rock and roll and punk all in one, and it's a distinctive sound, it must be said. Though the origins of psychobilly, I've just invented that word, are still debated. The Meteors are the first band to self-identify psychobilly, and are often credited with a distinction as being the only pure psychobilly sound ever to be recorded. Now, that's arrogance to the point of extreme. And I guess that's why I like them. And as I said earlier on, it does have that kind of Halloween-esqueness about it. Hail, hail, rock and roll. Oh, yeah, man. Oh, yeah. Hail, hail, rock and roll on Sunday night. Sunday night, we used to be. Monday night here at Oakfield FM, 8 minutes past eight. Thanks for your company, by the way. Grease Lightning, continuing our theme of transportation on Hail, hail, rock and roll. Now, if I was to say to you, we'll get some overhead lifts and some four-barrel quads, oh yeah. Fuel injection cutoffs and some chrome-plated rods, oh yeah. Yeah, I'll get the money. I'll get the money. Then you're one step away from being behind a microphone in any karaoke bar anywhere in the UK, particularly on a seashore, seafront, seaside, somewhere near you. That song is being sung tonight, and quite right too. Not necessarily played to death, but it does actually fit the theme of tonight's show, along with the next one, Get On Your Bike by Lucas and the Dynamos. Now, there can't be many bands who put their heart and soul and energy into every power chord that they play. You know what I mean by the power chord? Invented by Link Ray and Rayman. Well, they sort of get it right. Not as good as Link Ray did, but this band has been going for 17 years, and the hard work is certainly paying off. Lucas and the Dynamos got a great album out, and the boys are a force to be reckoned with. And they've all got British motorbikes as part of their theme, as part of their love for the music. And their lifestyle sort of continues on and off the microphone as well, with all five members having classic bikes. Hence, and quite rightly too, at the beginning of this song, features the rip-roaring sound of a Triumph. Hail, hail, rock and roll of a Monday night here at Oakfield FM. It is approaching a quarter past the hour of 80. Still with me? I'm glad you are, I've got to say. One of the most easily recognisable songs from Sun Records. Of course, I could have played you the Carl Perkins version of Blue Suede Shoes, but there really isn't any comparison with one Elvis Aaron Presley. He sort of kicks that 12-bar blues version from 1959 very well indeed. Up after the after of Pates and Bills here, I'll play. You know, I don't actually get that much opportunity to play you an instrumental, but I will after the break. Moving and grooving, continuing with our theme of transportation here on Hail Hail Rock and Roll. Moving and Grooving by Duane Eddy, I'll play you next. Although it was a hit for Duane Eddy in 1958, Wolverhampton City Council have used it as part of a massive drive to get kids moving and grooving. They did it last year in 2009 by the City Council Sports and Development Team. Anything to tear the little ones away from the TV and the computer games, although I don't think that was a real problem back in 1958. It's good to play an instrumental, and I'll play it for you next after I've paid these bills here at Oakfield FM.
Ever wanted the services of an in-house lawyer for your business without all the costs?
Hail, rock and roll of a Monday night here at Oakfield FM. Give some shouts on the way to the fabulous people that have chosen to listen online as well as on FM tonight. Give you a mention on the way. You've just heard Working on the Roadside by Doomsday Rockers from the 4-Minute Warning album. That's track number 6 on there if you want to go out and get it. A recent release for the Doomsday Rockers, that one. And it's their 4-Minute Warning album from Polytone Records, a fantastic label for the music that we're playing tonight. They're one of the few Teddy Boy bands that have ever featured in the NME magazine. So if that publication is all about picking up the next big trends, then hey, bring it on for another rockabilly revival. And I'd like to see one in my lifetime as well, because the music industry is worth a new change and a new direction. Let's hope it changes and faces us. Run Around Sue up next by the Firebirds from their Taken by Storm album. Now, if you don't actually know the story behind this song, it's a good little one, actually. It's a song about a man whose ex-girlfriend had commitment troubles and ran around, hence the name of the song. And the song caught on with millions for its catchy hook. You know, the one that goes, hey, hey, hum-de-da-de-dilly-diddly. That one, hum-de-da-de-dilly. You'll hear it in a minute. But according to the writers, Dion and the Del Satins, her name wasn't actually Sue. It was about some girl who loved to be worshipped, but as soon as you went and gave her some commitment and expressed her love for her, she had the opposite reaction and ran away. She had commitment faux problems. And the song you're going to hear is the Firebirds version of it. And we'll never know what the girl's real name was, but Sue will have to do for now.
Here's my story, it's sad but true.
Mm-hmm.
One of my favourite things on planet Earth is playing that song on radio and just hearing it in my headphones and hearing it on the speakers around the studio. Hail, hail, rock and roll of a Monday night, myself, Jason. It's 28 minutes past 8 and I'm still absolutely buzzing from playing that song. Sleepwalk is what it was called by Santo and Johnny. Santo and Johnny are an Italian-American rock duo from Brooklyn, comprising two brothers, Santo and Johnny Farina. They're best known for that instrumental track, Sleepwalk. And if you're a horror movie fan, you may remember it from being used on the movie Sleepwalk back in 1992. Mystery Train up next by Jerry Naylor, continuing with our theme of transportation on tonight's show. A little sub-theme going throughout tonight's show, all to do with transportation. Jerry Naylor and the Tribute to My Friends album, lead singer for the Crickets after the premature death of the great Buddy Holly. That's who Jerry Naylor is. I'll almost call him a rock and roll country crossover. He's a broadcaster as well in the United States now, and unlike myself, does indeed have a face for TV. Hail, rock and roll of a Monday night here at Oakfield FM. Thanks for your company. I'm just enjoying it, by the way. The people listening, by the way, wanted a quick shout. I'm very happy to do it for you here. Brian Hunt, Jules Camp, Leona, Megan Jones, Michael Chick, Rick Murray, Simon Yates, Tim Scott, Fraser Spence, Jeff Cullen, Kevin Huffer, Kevin Oldfield, Marcus Patrick, thank you very much for listening online tonight. And don't forget to listen on FM as well. And if you listen to us right now on FM, lock us on your presets and we'll only be a button away from you. On Monday nights from 7 until 9, giving you rock and roll, doo-wop, rockabilly and sun sound. You have just joined us. Well, let me tell you, there is a theme to tonight's show. It's transportation. You just heard Lamar, Beyond the Sea, performed by the Firebirds. See, transportation, Beyond the Sea. There is a story. It's an amazing, this is actually a connection between this song and the next song I'm going to play. Proving that rock and roll is rhythm driven. You listen to the rhythm of the rain, perhaps. Yeah, that was a Buddy Holly song. The rhythm of the train. Well, hence the connection with transport tonight. It was written in 10 minutes, that song, by a Frenchman called Charles Trent. Yeah, French, yeah, there really is a thriving rock and roll scene on the continent. The inspiration was gazing out of a train window at the Mediterranean. And a fabulous thought that is as well. And hence the rhythm of that song ticks along. Written in the space of 10 minutes by Charles Trent. Do you know, if that's the case, and there is a train that goes along the Mediterranean, and it's inspires you to write such good performances as that, I think I'll go and book my ticket now. So the connection between that and the next song is the fact that the next song was written in even less time. It was written in only 5 minutes. It's an amazing 2 minute song in itself, but it was written in 1960 when there was a famous meeting between Bobby Charles and Fats Domino. They never met for the first time, but the legend that is, Fats Domino says, come back to my place and we'll write some stuff together. But lacking transportation that night, they decided to walk, hence walking to New Orleans, and they wrote the song on the way to his house and then put it down on paper upon arrival. I'm walking to New Orleans. Hail, hail, rock and roll of a Monday night here at Oakfield FM. 20 minutes to 9 Greenwich Mean Time, or good music time as well. I've decided to call it tonight. The change of the clocks and the cold weather. I hope the songs perhaps warm you up a little bit. 200 Miles, continuing with our theme of transportation tonight. 200 Miles by Danny Wilde. Rock and roll, I have to say. Danny Wilde, if you don't actually know him, he was one of Shaken Stevens' backing singers when he was in the Sunsets, yeah? We've had one of Chuck Berry's backing singers tonight, but now one of Shaken Stevens. A band in his own right, doing his own thing. Glad he's doing it too. He's with a band called the Wildcats now, if you want to check him out. Next on our theme of transportation tonight is Long Gone Train by the Sugar Creek Trio. And there is a great photo of Betty Page on the Sugar Creek Trio's band website, I must say, if you're into Betty Page. And in the summer of 2004, they enjoyed a highly successful UK tour supporting none other than Jerry Lee Lewis, Chuck Berry, and in 2005 supported Little Richard on his tour as well. Now, if that doesn't give you credentials to be in a rockabilly band, then you've got a long way to go. I'll say it again, I like the sound of it so much. Hail, hail, rock and roll. Oh yeah, man. Now then, if you're enjoying the show tonight, you may have noticed there is a theme which connects all these songs as transportation, with planes, trains, automobiles, cars, legs, even a UFO at one point with the old Sun Sound Records. You've just heard Pipeline. There's a form of transportation. And it was a very good instrumental as well by the Doomsday Rockers. Doomsday Rockers are waiting for a train back to Northampton, their hometown, and they're still waiting for that train today. And it's almost like an ongoing gag in rockabilly circles to say that about the Doomsday Rockers. Have they got that train yet? There's also a well-known boat that floats in the Thames estuary with a great big mast that has a connection with the Doomsday Rockers. I'll let you look that one up in line without actually advertising another radio station. But Sea of Heartache is up next, continuing with our theme, and I'll play it directly after the ads, but I'll just introduce it first before I do. It's by Don Gibson, Sea of Heartache, his version. And a lot of people do enjoy coming up to me and telling me something that I already know. And that is that some very early rock and roll sounds did actually sound similar to country. Well, you know, blues and country became rock and roll, so I see the connection. At least I think that's what they were saying, anyway, to a lesser extent. But the argument is made by me that Beetle Crusher shoes are much better than cowboy boots. Find out after I've paid these bills here at Uckfield FM.
At Lawson Commercial.
Hail rock and roll here at Uckfield FM. It's 54 minutes past the hour of 8. Almost time to play another couple of songs for a girl, I've got to say. If you're enjoying the rock and roll tonight, the Sun Sound, the doo-wop, the rockily, more of it to come next Monday, in fact, between 7 and the hours of 9. I'll take a few requests there as well. Theme show tonight, though, the theme of transportation. Well, one with cars. One with something completely different next. Well, let me just tell you about, yeah, you've just heard Gotta Get a Mercury by the Baltimores. Now, I love the album that comes from. It's one of those incredible compilations from Polytone called Teddy Boy Rock and Roll, The Next Chapter. There are a few of them in the series that came out in the early noughties, and, well, put together by Val at the record label. Lots of songs on there about cars tonight that help you be able to put this show together. Thank you very much to her and all the people that have managed to contribute to tonight's show with their rocking music. Spaceship to Mars continuing up next as our themed show by the Blue Jays, this one. I have a personal connection with this song and this band. I shared a rock and roll stage with these guys. Well, two, in fact. And we had a blast. It was one of those rock and roll weekenders, or hops, I guess you call them, as they were known back in the 1950s. This one was at the Vauxhall Holiday Park in Great Yarmouth. And they tell me they wrote this one in a tribute to the 1950s Hollywood B-movies. That was the big sci-fi scare drive-in movies of the time. And, you know, if I could go back in time, I'd love to have that experience. Go to a drive-in movie with some girl at your side, some top rolled down, someone roller skating up to you with a hot dog, and your soft drink. Of course, it would have to be a soft drink because you'd be driving on the way home, or you might end up on a spaceship to Mars. And roll of a Monday night here at Uckfield FM. It's very nearly news time. You have been listening to Transportation as our theme of our Hail Hail Rock and Roll show. In fact, this song comes from the Chuck Berry album called Hail Hail Rock and Roll. It's a good one to finish on. Back again next Monday from the hours of 7 until 9 with doo-wop, rockabilly, and those great classic Sun Sound songs from Sam Phillips' recording studio in Tennessee. It's the Overnighter on the way next here at Uckfield FM. And if you're just discovering us for the very first time on your radios, don't forget to lock us on your presets to that frequency, and we'll only be a button away from giving you good songs just like this every Monday between the hours of 7 and 9. Breakfast back again tomorrow. Hope you'll join them there bright and early, and don't forget to keep us online as well. Keep on rocking.
Your community, your station. This is Uckfield FM.
Jacktop slamming, 49 Mercury Blue.
Hail, hail, rock and roll. How you doing? Of a Monday night here at Uckfield FM. Very, very cold. I'm just going to try and keep you warm with a bit of rock and roll. 49 Mercury Blues. 49, actually, the 49 Mercury actually kicks off a very interesting show tonight, all about transportation, kicking off with a car. We'll have trains, planes, automobiles, a UFO. Use your legs in a moment. 49 Mercury was the first independently designed, built V8 engine, as Jeremy Clarkson will probably tell you. It was produced by Ford, the Ford Motor Company, in mass production, and worshipped with that opening number by the rock and roll showman Brian Stetzer and his orchestra, frontman from the Stray Cats. Now, there is a theme to tonight's show. I'm kicking off with the biggest man in rock and roll you could possibly get. The theme of transport is the name of the game tonight. I suppose you can spot how many different ones I go to. I'm going to go from Wheels to Legs next with Walk Like a Man by the Four Seasons. This was recorded by the Four Seasons in the middle of the night, and I love this story because it's so rock and roll. This story recorded in the middle of the night in a burning building by a producer called Crew, that was his name, who produced many other big things, but one thing he did do that night was lock the band in while the entire building was on fire, and he wouldn't let the Four Seasons out until he'd actually recorded the final note, and the fire department actually had to break in and get all members of the Four Seasons out and to safety. Do you know, thinking about it, thank goodness they didn't break in too soon, or we wouldn't have had this particular piece of material. Hail, hail, rock and roll of a Monday night. It's 11 minutes past 7. Thanks for your company. Sea Cruise by the Skyrockers. One of Shaken Stevens' first classic album tracks, that, as I remember. You may remember Dion and the Belmonts did it first of all, but I've chosen the Skyrockers version for you. And man, what a band, the Skyrockers there. It's a good example of a band on today's circuit touring this very land of ours and keeping the rockabilly movement alive. And you can catch them on YouTube after this show. Long Gone Down the Road is the next one up. It's by the Doomsday Rockers, staying as we are all night with our theme of transportation. Sea Cruise, Long Gone Down the Road, transportation. Starting life in 1948, this song is an instrumentals track. Despite its revving rockabilly sound, it inspired a recent 2008 hit by Chris Connell. Now, if you like to please everyone at the same time, he released it both in a rock version and as a rap version as well. I'm afraid I will not be playing any rap tonight, because that's not what I'm all about. But the Doomsday Rockers, I do feel, is worthy of a little bit of note, as they are also available to see on YouTube after this show.
A bad way, bring it back to me. Oh, please hear my plea.
Hail, hail, rock and roll for Monday night. How are you doing? This is Jason. White Cadillac on our theme of transportation here on Hail, Hail, Rock and Roll. White Cadillac by the Black Cats, made up of Flying Flynn on drums, Tom Cat Tony on vocals, Mr. Soul on slab bass, and Fat Abra on electric bass and vocals. Rocking together since 1981, by the way. And if you're interested, a White Cadillac is an alcoholic beverage consisting of scotch and milk in equal parts over ice. For added flavour, you could even try even putting a bit of a white chocolate liqueur in there as well. It coming up to Christmas and you wanting to put on a few pounds and all. Up next, Lonesome Train by the Sugar Creek Trio, which I'll play directly after the break. Now, this song most notably sang by the great Johnny Burnett, also sang Over Its Time by J.J. Cale, also the Doomsday Rockers, the Meteors, Gary Glitter sang it once. But the best version of this song you've yet to hear. It's by the Sugar Creek Trio, and this adds new life to the song. It's all sort of cut back to basics, and it's so raw. I absolutely love it, and I envy you if you are hearing this song for the very first time. The hairs must just stand up on the back of your neck. But you know what? I'm going to make you wait until after the break to hear it on Hail, Hail, Rock and Roll here at Uckfield FM. Hail, hail, rock and roll of a Monday night here at Uckfield FM. 25 minutes past 7, you're listening to the house band, who are, of course, the Firebirds. Well, you know, you got to have a house band. And they're mine. If you want to go check them out, it's www.firebirds.com and rockfieldrecords.org. And it's always good to hear them played here on Hail, Hail, Rock and Roll. 59 Ford by the amazing Firebirds. Now, the Ford Thunderbird, to give it its full name, the Ford Thunderbird Convertible, was the song that about the car was mentioned. 59 Ford on the way in just a moment's time. It's difficult to write a song that hasn't been sung before, says the Firebirds. And if you're going to sing a song about anything, you may as well sing it about a car, because it kind of goes well with all we're trying to do here on our transportation theme here. Now, 59 for Ford has a connection with our next song in the fact that Marty Wilde wrote it in 1959. And back in the days when the Yanks came out with smash hits, it was converted into this country by one of our own. It's not fashionable anymore for an artist stateside to go and sing a song and then have someone over here sing the same song rather than have the original one released over here. Because nowadays, things cross the Atlantic so easily at the touch of a button. But back then, it was all the rage. So Miley Wilde's version of Sea of Love isn't the original, but the original was by Phil Phillips and got to number 100 in the Billboard 100 and did rather well for Kim Wilde's dad. And you may remember the opening bars to this song. I'm sure over the years, this has appeared in the Chanel No. 5 advert. That's not product placement, by the way. Hail rock and roll of a Monday night here at Upfield FM. Rocket 88, Ike Turner, not just a car of its day, but accredited by all musicians as being the very first rock and roll song of all time ever. Every song you hear on the radio today can trace its roots back to that song and the genius of rock and roll. It was performed by Ike Turner, like I say, Tina's ex, and just for the history books, the birth of rock and roll was the 3rd of March 1951, and the place was Sam Phillips Recording Studio in Memphis, Tennessee. From America to the UK, Breakfast at the Ace now, as our theme of transport continues through rock and roll here. This is quite a good one, because back in the early 60s, the Ace Cafe on London's North Circular was a legendary meeting place for what was known as the Tun Boys. Named so because they'd put a penny in a jukebox, jump onto their motorbikes, drive as fast as they can, well, 100 miles an hour, down to a set of traffic lights, then back again to the Ace Cafe at said 100 miles an hour, reaching the finish line before the needle ran out on the record. Now that's how to pull chicks. Hail rock and roll here at Upfield FM. Quick shouts tonight, by the way, to Sammy Mobbs, Emily Lee, Francis Knoll, Fraser Spence, Jeff Cullen, Jackie Brown, Kevin Huffer, Malcolm Eccles, Marcus Patrick, Megan Jones, Val Bird, Dayarushi Maharaji, Kevin Oldfield, Lucy Norris and Serge Chapman. Thank you very much for listening to the show and contacting us. You too can contact the show. You can do it in one of several ways. You can go onto Facebook and look up Jason Rushworth. Dead easy. It's the only Jason Rushworth sat on a camel. Well, who else would be? You can also email studio@upfieldfm.co.uk. Go to www.upfieldfm.co.uk and click on Contact a Show. If you want to text as well, you can text Upfield, then your message to 810. Your messages are charged at normal text standard rate. Now you know, you've been warned. Just heard Runaway Boys. You may also have figured out the theme of tonight's show, which is all about transport through the years of rock and roll. This one from 1981 by the amazing Stray Cats, bringing rockabilly to life back in 1981 when all that glam sourpuss stuff was going on. What really brought glam to the music scene in 1981 was the rockabilly revival. You'll hear a lot of it here on this show, offering up a brace of rock and roll revitalism in the syntho-pop loving 80s. I do particularly love the slap bass on that particular one. Now then, up next, She Walked Right In by The Avengers. Now, they named themselves after the 60s British super detectives, The Avengers. Probably the Gareth Hunt version, actually. But anyway, signed by Ray Records in the States, and I have to call them Boogie Woogie Rock and Roll here, for want of a better expression or way to describe this band. There's a certain amount of class in the album of The Avengers, She Walks Right In, and I'd love to go to one of their gigs just to see how people dress. Already on the opening notes, you can tell it's a classy song. Oh yeah, man. Hail rock and roll of a Monday night here at Upfield FM. 10 minutes to 8. Got to pause and pay some bills here in just a moment's time. But right after that, you'll get Chuck Berry. You've just heard Flying Saucers Rock and Roll by the Wildcats, who are a rockabilly blues bopping three-piece band. The Wildcats are formed in 1993 by singer and guitarist Dave Buddy X. And that's a name to have if you're in a band. Oh, did I mention they do blues as well? The song Flying Saucers Rock and Roll is actually a parody of the 1950s sci-fi B-movies, which I rather like, not just as a concept of a song, but just in the way it sounds as well. The Total and the King of Rock and Roll up next. And I'm not talking about Elvis, I'm talking about Buddy Holly, right after I've paid these bills here at Upfield FM.